Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I am going to teach you a couple of tricks to work with Farsi verbs. Let's start with a very simple verb. The verb to go, in Farsi we have raftan. So if you pay attention here, the infinitive in English, to go, gives us access to the present tense. That is why we can say things like I go, you go, he or she goes, and so on and so forth. So as you can see, the infinitive go will appear here in all the present tense conjugations, right? Now in Farsi, what happens is when you look at the infinitive, the part of the verb that you see in the infinitive, in fact, has nothing to do with the present tense. It gives you access to the past tense. So remember, that's a very big difference between the English infinitive and the Farsi infinitive. So what does this mean? It means if we look at raftan, it gives us access to simple past, went. So for example, when we say raftam, it actually would mean I went rather than I go. So remember the trick. Here you're looking at the past stem, not the present stem. So raftam, I went, and rafti, you went. You remember that in Farsi, the way that we work with verbs is we conjugate, which means the ending will change based on the person. So, am is added to a verb when we are talking about I. I went. Raftam. And e is added to a verb when we're talking about you, singular informal. Remember that in Farsi we have two versions of you. Either we're talking to someone informally, a friend, a family member, or we talk to a person formally, for example, if you're talking to someone who's older than you. Now, in the case of formal you, the ending is not E, the ending will be actually in. So for example, in this case, if you say raftin, this means you formal went, or you plural went, and you're talking to more than one person. So remember, that's another important point, that in Farsi there is actually a difference between you formal and you informal. So E has to do with informal you, and in has to do with formal you. This is for another lesson, but I just wanted you to actually review that concept. We have talked about this before. Now, this is about past tense verbs, simple past. How do we make simple present? Let's have a look. So basically in Farsi, again, as I said, the present tense verb has nothing to do with the infinitive. So in this case, if you look at raftan, you cannot really figure out what would be I go or you go. So how do we figure out the present stem? The answer is simply memorization, because honestly, there is no logical process through which you can conclude what is the present stem. So in the case of this verb, raftan, the present stem is simply the letter R in conversational Farsi. Again, here, this channel is about conversational Farsi. We're talking only about Farsi that's spoken by people and is used by people. So we're going to put the present stem. Now, how do we say I go? Can you guess? You have the stem. Okay, for I, the ending is am, as we just saw. And let's say for you go, the ending, you informal, will be E. Okay. So far, so good. Now, here's the trick. Remember, all present tense verbs in Farsi, they have a handle. They have a prefix. And that prefix is actually me. So it is a fixed prefix that you will need to put right there, right before the beginning of the verb, basically. And it will mean that you're dealing with a present tense verb, if you see the present stem also, of course, you know. So you have the handle, me, you have the present stem, R, and then you have the ending. Okay, so three components. One more time, I go. We put the present stem, we put the ending, but also we need to put a handle. Mira, you go, miri. Okay, so you can use the same formula with all present tense verbs with the exception of to be and to have, which means if you want to say something like I see, I come, any verb in present tense, you will hear me at the beginning of those verbs, followed by the present stem, and then the ending. Okay? So I hope you enjoyed this lesson. It was a short lesson just to show you quickly the difference between past and present tense verbs. Obviously, there are so many other verb tenses in Farsi. In fact, there are around 9 or 10 verb tenses that native speakers use on a daily basis. If you're curious about those verb tenses, or if you're interested in learning more, you can check out my book, 110 Conversational Verbs in Farsi, on my website. I will put a link under the video. Click on it and check it out. And also, in the next video, I will explain a little bit more about other tenses and how you can work with them. So stay tuned. Ta-bat!